Represent each situation with an integer, plot the integers on the number line, then determine the sum of the integers. For the first example, we have a loss of $25 and a gain of $25. For a loss of $25, we use the integer negative 25, and for a gain of $25, we use the integer positive 25. And now let's plot these on the number line. Let's first plot 0. Negative 25 is 25 units to the left of 0, and positive 25 is 25 units to the right of 0. Notice these two integers have the opposite sign, but they are the same distance from 0. Both are 25 units from 0, meaning their opposite values are equal. This indicates negative 25 and positive 25 are opposites. And now let's determine their sum. We could model this using the number line. For negative 25, we would start at 0 and move left 25 units to negative 25. And then from here, because we're adding positive 25, we would move 25 units to the right of negative 25, which notice brings us back to 0, which indicates the sum is 0. In general, the sum of opposites is always 0. For the second example, we have 12 degrees above 0 and 12 degrees below 0. For 12 degrees above 0, we use the integer positive 12. For 12 degrees below 0, we use the integer negative 12. And now we plot the integers on the number line. With 0 in the middle, positive 12 is 12 units to the right of 0, and negative 12 is 12 units to the left of 0. And once again, notice the integers have opposite signs, but are the same distance from 0. 12 and negative 12 are opposites. And now let's model the sum. The sum is 12 plus negative 12. For positive 12, from 0 we move right 12 units. And then because we're adding negative 12 from positive 12, we move left 12 units, which again brings us back to 0. The sum is 0. I hope you found this helpful.